Women's Art History, page number 204. Meeting with Hatha Yogi. She reached by crossing the several states from London to India, to the jungle of Uttar Pradesh, her own state, where she brought up while leaving the Sahajadi Begum in London. She heard about the Hatha Yogi, practicing the Hatha Yoga at the bank of river in the jungle. She moved to him. After walking 6 days daily, 6 hours daily, she gets him. There is nobody else. A very thick, dangerous jungle. Anybody could scare off it. He was doing some yogic practices. Gina saw him from afar. He is tall but lean body, scattered hairs, long beard, bearing lingot of animal skin only. She moved slowly, slowly towards him. He was still closing his eyes. He was looking such different that before calling him, she has to collect her strength. Suniye, listen, she speaks in very slow voice. There is no response. Suniye, this time she speaks in some higher tone. He opens his eyes. His eyes are red and very broad. Who are you? He shouts on her. Gee, she stamped on hearing his loud voice. He sees her in anger. She was shivering with fear. She was wearing salwar kameez, which is dirty and dry face, as she did not eat for some days. She is looking very, very pathetic. Why don't you speak? He shouts again. But this time Gina did not reply and get faint. Why you come here? Gina opened her eyes. There is the same Hatha Yogi. She is lying on the stone under the tree. He is sitting there on the stone near her. She tries to sit, but pain in her head not allows this. You are very weak. Saying this, he gives her the water from mud pot. She drinks. Now she is able to speak. I heard about you. Will you please accept me as your disciple? No, he said firmly. Just return to your home and do not move back towards me again. I will not go anywhere. She shouts over him. I came here to learn not to return. I will not return. You are disturbing me. I not. I will be here and learn from you. He remains silent for some minutes. He is spelling the spirit in her voice that she will not move back. Okay, both take a sigh. But you have to live like Hatha Yogi. I will, she said. Then first of all, shave your hairs and change your clothes with the animal skin kept near to you. You are my disciple from right now. She did the same. There are 8 steps of this sadhana. He starts telling her, yam, niyam, asan, pranayam, etc. For how many years you are practicing? 35 years. So long period. Yes, it is a yogic sadhana. So forget the past life. Yes. First you have to obey me in all circumstances. Without obedience, there is no learning and growth in the Hatha Yoga. From that day, she started the Hatha Yoga. Some days could eat fruit or milk and some days water only. It is strict sarir tan, breaking all the normal routines of body, lying on the land full of insects in the chilling nights, and for some nights she has to do some hectic yet Hatha Yoga sadhana. By doing this, you would get the power over fire, water and wind. By doing all this, her body lost all its attraction. Her eyes grows weaker. Hairs forget to grow again on saved hair. She is looking like a skeleton. This goes on for 2 years. This is end of the chapter, page 206. Start of transmission. Today, when she closed her eyes, she felt a light in her chest, near to the neck. She wandered for that light. She again closed her eyes, but not find again. Next day, there is similar thing, but with jerks and a stronger light. She again searched inside. Then she stands up and looked for that has done the same. She moved inside the jungle. She finds that Hatha Yogi was sitting there and has fire around him. He sits there to wait so that his sadhana would finish. After waiting for much time, he opens his eyes. After few minutes of it, he pays attention on her. I felt jerk with light in heart. I again searched it in me, but find nothing. So I start searching the same in open jungle. Jin said, jerk with light, he murmured, and then closed his eyes to read the matter. After few minutes, he opens the eyes. What have you done, Jinath? I am reading the environment during sadhana. Some spirits attracted and come closer. There is a spirit who is here, and it also contacted you yesterday. He again closed his eyes. There are some unusual jerks in his body. He released long breath and sees the Jinath very deeply. You are not here for Hatha Yoga sadhana. I did the mistake. That spirit is angry with me. You are my guru, Jinath said. Therefore, I am responsible because you only obey me. I have to read the matter first, only then guide you, Hatha Yoga said. Then what would happen, Jinath said. All my sadhana is now blotted because I committed a serious mistake. Now sit in meditation. I will help you to contact that spirit. Both sit by closing their eyes. Both of them are looking so terrible that if anybody would see, he will scare off them. The light steps down in the heart of Yogi. He remains in the same position for half an hour. He opens the eyes. Jinath is still sitting by closing her eyes. Open your eyes, Hatha Yogi said. She opens her eyes and looks at him. Her dress of animal skin is hiding till knees. You are here for transmission. Yes, that spirit will give transmission now for some months or maybe for lifelong. Months, why not in once for all? It will burst your heart. So give you transmission still keeping you alive. It will give us in months. Oh, Jinath says in low pitch. Side by side, your heart will also clean. So the grossness you collected through this practice of Hatha Yoga and the actions of past will be cleaned. Again he closed his eyes. Jinath has lost all her senses, so can't feel the joy that she has got her master. She is a lean body lady. All flesh of her body is burned in Hatha sadhana. At this time in her last dress, there could be four Jinath instead of one. It is 4 a.m. Both of them sit under the tree. Before this, they take bath in chilled water of the river. They closed their eyes like normally they did. Senses of hot or cold has lost in some time. Now they seemed like not in the same world. A light falls upon them. They felt uneasy as it covered them tightly, very strong jerk like, falling from very high. The Hatha Yogi, lost in a vision, appears before him in closed eyes, like light falls upon a shiny rock and reflected back. Jinath sees in a vision that a rock built there is melting, with the light fall on it. Wet silt starts flowing from her structure. The vision of all Hatha Yoga practices appeared in a glimpse before her. Silt is flowing for so long period that she feels yuck, but it did not stop. She is able to see it very, very clearly. After hourly long process, she feels that the Jina sees in a vision that a rock built there is melting with the light fall on it. Wet silt starts flowing from her structure. The vision of all Hatha Yoga practices appeared in a glimpse before her. Silt is flowing for so long period that she feels yuck. But it did not stop. She is able to see it very, very clearly. After hourly long process, she feels some easy and a very thin line of light entered into her heart. It continues for more than an hour. Then she feels enlightened in her heart. She feels a clear instinct in her heart. Second day. Nothing new for Hatha Yogi. He opens his eyes with frustration, but soon after that he again sat in the meditation. A clear instinct in his heart, he felt that you have to bait, because the grossness you collected with practice of Hatha Yoga is like a rock in your heart. So starting off your journey will take time. Have patience and do the meditation on heart in the natural way. Jinnat sees a clear picture. There is a blue old house never seen before. There is a girl aged approximately 12 years having raw rice in the plate. Face was not clear. Then she sees following visions. In next scene, same girl is playing in courtyard, her hopscotch sequoia. That girl rushed to a room. Then in next scene, the same girl was hanging herself in the room. Vision was very clear. Then divine light enters in her and she feels clear jerks of that. She left in between because of pain, but suddenly all negativity of a universe flows towards her. It dried her like a dry leaf. She holds her head, then that divine light fills her heart vision. A clear instinct strikes in her heart. There is no vacuum in the whole universe. In the process of cleaning of your past sanskara, there creates a vacuum, and that must be filled with divine light. Otherwise, the thoughts will rush towards like it a wind, and it will grossed up with all negativity in the universe. After that, she opens her eyes. She realized the same while recalling her past. On so many occasions, she thought about suicide in the difficulties of life. The Pramahuti starts working on her with cleaning her old sanskar fixed in the heart vision. Nobody needs to tell her as Pratyaksham Kim Pramaham. Now the adventurous journey begins. She sits daily closing her eyes, and this power worked upon her. She experienced daily in her journey. Now Jinnat herself will tell you the further story. My part of storytelling is finished now. Today, after some time, I feel a storm inside me of black coal particles having some sign in it. It was too fast and also growing fast with passing of each moment. Whole body turned in those black particles in very thick layer. I hate myself on seeing this condition of my body. I remain sit for much time. With applying all my force, I start screaming inside for help as I sunk into it and felt suffocated of it. Then after some time, when it becomes extremely gross, divine light start cleaning it. That dirty coal turned into smoke and start releasing from my back. This process remains continue for more than an hour. I am feeling like a stone kept on the mouth of the big pot is removed from my back and a hole created of it. It is a clear view. I am brooding over all my experience during the meditation. I felt the negativity increased at my every stage of life. In past, even a single small problem breaks me. I am feeling better, cured from inside. Next, during meditation, a thought has come that I am a woman, therefore faced such a bad luck. The clear answer was there that spirit is neither male nor female. Then another question rose in her mind that nobody will love me, even nature itself. Again received clear answer. For holding something, you have to leave something. For receiving transmission, through meditation, I have to get empty my heart pot and clean it, otherwise it will transmit back. Next, in meditation there are the stars of galaxy. I am thinking in that they are moving very fast in circular motion. I am going inside deeper and deeper. Whole day I felt pain on top of my head. There is no much communication between me and Hatha Yogi. Next, I feel I am in the bomb of someone, feeling strong security and light surrounded me as well as inside me. There is silence, a wordless silence. The tone of talking is very slow and humble. Whole day I spent in such silence. Things around me like animals, blowing of wind, river, etc. Nothing disturbs this silence. It is deep rooted. A big size, tall like a man gutter inside me. It is flowing profusely from heart. Even after all my efforts, I am unable to escape from it. It is so dirty that I am trying forcefully either to remove it or clean it once for all. After cleaning, a feeling of lightness fills me. Next, there is a big old gate of a house, a strong light. Then on crossing the passage of the light, I reached to a tunnel filled of light, in which I am moving inside. Next, started meditation in sleepy condition, but after a few minutes, feel strong jerks and alertness inside. Today I am in such a sleepy condition that it was unable to wake up and sit for meditation, but not sleep during a whole period of meditation. It was a surprise in itself, as even having all elements available for sleep, yet not sleep. During meditation, a strong flow of negativity disturbed me. On feeling unable to overcome, requested for help, and help is at your gate. A large soft seed of divine light is spread over me and soaks all negativity. Then again a tunnel full of light, and I start moving inside it. I have to stand for a few minutes as a small deer starts smelling me and licking at my shoulder. I fall on the ground as my legs are jammed. Again sits for meditation, and at this time feel like my whole body is turning into a sheet of water, green water. It is a strange condition. I am melting into that water sheet. Next, I am feeling less negativity than yesterday, feeling strong jerks in meditation. Next, feeling continuous weakness inside, but why? Not cleared. Next, during sleeping, I heard a clear voice, "I love you more than life and death." During meditation, feeling like moving up above in the sky, and head is above the clouds. Clouds are running around me over the shoulder. Next, a vision of Dev appears in meditation. There is some feeling in the heart. I remain disturbed somewhat. The answer is, transmission removes the sanskar, but sometimes a slight impression of those plays a role in the life, so need not to worry, it is a very slight impact. Next, remains disturbed whole day due to remembrance of past, why all my efforts were ruined. Whether meditation provides only spirituality, not perfection in materialistic life? ? In this deep thought, sits in meditation, goes deeper and deeper. The condition grows lighter. Suddenly the instincts received in the heart. Meditation means having something. When you already have something, then why begging? You become what you meditate, that is continuous thinking about something. If thinking of the fire, then you receive the hotness of fire. I open the eyes. Whole day I felt pain on my head. Next, what is the meaning of this all aimless success? Why should I do karma? Whole day these thoughts keep on churning in the brain. During a meditation of next day, feeling like going far and far into the divine light and also present in heart. Sees a big statues of Gautam Buddha, feels a strong attraction. There is aura behind his head. Enlightened rays are spreading from him, drawing her towards the statue forcefully. Afterwards, these rays completely cover me inside. Next, a woman like a huge monster or giant hanging in the vision, but this is not the same as previous one. Next, doubts are removing now. Jab tak main tha, tab tu nahi, ab tu hai, main na hai. Until I was there, you were absent. Now you are there, only not me. A thought strikes into mind. Nature sends the person to the place which he person chooses without asking who you are. So we have the power of choices, a dangerous weapon in hands of human being. Failures and negativity are the products of our own thoughts and attitudes. Karma is not only doing things with physical body. It is the imitation of the things already created in upper world through our thoughts or past sanskars. Further in meditation, there are different temples and deities never seen before in past life. A door also I have seen there. That is a surprising view. Suddenly a clear voice heard. These are the impressions of your past births. Just ignore, do not concentrate. Next, dangerous fire inside the heart during meditation and in just few moments, a totally different thing. I don't know what it is. Cover the whole body. I am feeling something on the top, above the head. I have searched in own material heart and then find dialogue, less peace of meditation. Next, I am feeling lightness in body and heart. A thought of leaving Sajadi Begum clicks in brain. Less tension today, a lot of sleep during the day. In meditation, feel things like moving around me itself. A divine light is flowing on the head, on its uppermost part. This has speed in it. Also some pain on the head and heart. Seeing the statue of Krishna, but there is a clear warning that does not pay attention on it, as it is only past expression, not darshan of God. Feeling pain in the bone of the nose inside, and this pain moves towards the teeth. A thought strikes in the mind during a whole day, as all my past impressions are removed. So there would be no chance to fall as well as return to Wellwater. Next, during meditation, body is seemed to be converted into divine light. Feeling like stretching on the forehead and ears, a very sharp stretching. It lasts for 1 hour. Then a vision appears, a lady bearing garland around the neck, the desires of heart feeling melted. In present life also, I have unusual attraction towards dressing with flowers, garlands, etc. Next, a thought suddenly comes into the mind that I have so bad past sanskar that throws me into Wellwater. But Bhagavad Gita and transmission power creates the difference which is not available to all. Feeling vibration and jerks in meditation. A lot of impurities, grossness washed into meditation. Meditation is deep. A positive wave thrilled all the day long. Let's die on that beam. Let love a dream deadly. Now the support of nature is with me. Forget everybody. Now I am committed to myself only. Agar mehbooba se isk hai, to uski saheliyon se bhi to jari hai. If loved to the beloved, then also have friendship with her female friends. If I love the roses, then why hate the pain of thorns of it? Transmission fees whole day. Please stop this entire test by fire of my life. Please remove all the failures. My faith becomes weak till the end of the day. Even I charged it many times. Negativity starts spreading over me and fear grows in me. Please do not throw me out of your shelter. I am crying for you. Next, I have tried a lot during past several years to get rid of these sanskar. Thoughts haunted me, makes me mad, but I was failed. With the help of transmission, it creates magic in just few days. Not even a month have passed. I am feeling continuous transmission. My heart is like boiling. I feel like somebody make a hole in my back with a stroke or kick, and all sanskars stored in the heart removes as the steam from boiler. This process remain continuous whole day. I'm feeling pain whole day in heart. I faced hatred, grief, lust, insult, cheating from all, so it is hard to believe what is going on inside me, whether it is true, question mark. Whether it is really a reality. Next, today I give my heart and brain to you. Now there is nothing in place of both limbs in the body. Goods once sold will not be returned back. I died today, no heart, no brain. Whole body is like an envelope. Gurudev, do anything with these parts of body, but please do not return back. Please does not return these things back to me. Please, I will practice positivity from now and also remove negativity from whole structure continuously 24 hours. I am feeling control of you over me. Peace is everywhere. Sensitivity increased. Next, I dream I saw a saint smiling. A tear was rolled out of his one eye. In another dream, he was correcting the hole of chimney to make the way for removing smoke outside. If your cup is already filled, then how can you fill more wine in it? So for feeling divine pleasure and joy of adventurous journey to your inner self, you have to clean your heart from negativity and past. Nobody could ever make a castle over the past. Without transmission, it is impossible. It burns the seeds of past sanskar. The word bijdagdh is used for this only. I feel vibhuti jinat from inside me and feeling more lightness in the structure than before. Next, a thought comes into mind. Remove your creation and his creation will appear. There is nothing success or failure. Only growth is reality. From immovable to movable, then go towards being humans. Non-living things also grows, but their sensitivity level is so low, so can't respond to the change like human beings. So feeling of gratitude filled in me like that I never feel before. In night during meditation, feeling like whole body is burning and converting into a skeleton. Then this skeleton also leaves. Sensitivity also lost for some time. Continuous divine light is flowing on the head. Lightness increased from yesterday. In morning, feeling mojak at the sikha, top of the head. I feel something continuously. I am positive. Whatever my present, but my future will be bright and shining. I am becoming light and light. Meditation goes deeper. Why should I think only my future? Why not about the hunger pupil of the society? I am selfless. Next, my own negativity attracts those bastards. Then why should I blame God? Because I want them to be near to me, so they come. Due to this or that reason, I don't want to go near them, maybe whatever reason. I want to prove myself that only I can stand firm in all hardest situations of the life. So nature sends me the same to face and prove. In meditation, I feel pain in both sides of my forehead, felt like a pointed point behind the left ear. Rajyog works on the power of thoughts. Rajyog is king of yoga. Sri Krishna said to the Arjuna, practice Rajyog. Next, it will be a great idea to make life better on the earth of all creatures through the use of transmission. I am feeling like liquid or pus is flowing from my heart. A new idea came to the heart. I sit and thought like I am in deep sea of joy and sea waves are flowing through me from left to right and all my impurities are getting washed by them. Whole body converted into solid statue made of black particles having some sign in it. I am feeling yuck after 1 hour. Feeling on the backbone, a big size lotus flower is blooming. Different flowers may be related to in posture of dance are moving out of heart. It is long chain. Then whole body is seemed to be made of small statues. Then seeing a strange palace made of a small statue, body turns lighter. From lower part of the head, something in liquid form was flowing continuously, feeling like sinking in depth. Next, heart is melting so I feel like weeping, but Gurudev, divine person, sends me instinct. Just try to overcome it. In meditation, see a girl in militant dress. Something is flowing outside from body. Feeling hot at the back. Feeling like a small place of heart is cleaned through this process. Some mechanical instruments are coming out of heart. What was I in previous birth? I am shocked with all these outcomes of meditation. Next, meditate for 10 minutes. The goal now set for future, a balancing approach. So I can throw my desired power into right direction. Same attracts same. Street dogs not barked at everyone. We transmit our energy to dogs by fearing from them and vigils in barking and cutting, biting. Next, nature gives what we choose for us. Thieves have thieves as friends, not scientists. So be careful, have fear of choices. Nature is full of unlimited opportunities of growth. Do not use your willpower for your own destruction. In meditation, I feel head above the sky. Next, there were thoughts of Thakur Bikram Singh, Ifroz and Director Kapoor. Whole day, feeling like victim of destiny. It is easy to see the evil in anything. Difficult to see the goodness. Every person has everything in him like seven soul. Bubbles of Indian music, of Sangeet. Depending on which button you press, what you want to see, it appears before you. Feeling hatred to whole world before doing meditation and it grows stronger than before. Then in meditation, answer received us. Till today, I practice only hatred and seeing evils in others. A strong jerk, I felt a storm or tornado blunder of black particles released and flied out of the body. For some moment, I am surrounded by this storm, but then a wonderful feeling I received. Black bricks, gross black hard seat are broken and throwing outside me. Then with flow of water, which washed the area, and released black dirty water, flowing continuously. It is a terrifying experience. I am seeing a sage with long white beard, smiling. A small plant is planted inside me. Then my whole body turns transparent and only that plant is there. Next, today I am feeling like some mud pots full of stones of different varieties inside me. I tried them to throw out, but all my efforts are of no use. I pray for help. My faith is growing weak. Next, in dream, a person was speaking something. Face was not clear. First of all, don't concentrate on persons, otherwise his negativity will be transmitted towards you. Concentrate on the work or duties and leave everything on nature. Second thing, he said that if you want to know the event happened at any place, just increase your sensitivity. That will enable you to read the environment because every thought and action since the beginning of universe exists in the environment. Now remove impressions of persons so much peace will be empty in your heart, then fill it with the divine light. Next, I am feeling shower of divine light flowing on me. In meditation, there are flowers, different structures, ladies, Lord Krishna, etc. There is a garden on photo of a lady which placed before the gate of an old house. There is also a rock. Then all these things, visions, melted like colors of a whole painting, start mixing with the help of brush. This solution of different colors traveled in the whole body and released in form of smoke from the back. I am crying a lot, as I am ashamed to forget the divine source which has created me. I am very mean and idiot person. Now from today, no stupid imagination. A person wearing white dhoti and long shawl on his shoulder is there. Waves are moving in body from down to upside. A divine was inserted into head and flowing into up to bottom of the body, feeling light pain. Next, seeing a woman like monster in meditation, having long thick hairs on her whole body. Who is she? There are two girls throwing stones with their hands. I am feeling a wheel running in the place between neck and heart and releasing balm smoke. Next, in meditation there is a long, dangerous, heavy, fearful cobra. Initially for some moment, my body is converted into cobra. I am trembling with fear. Someone is drawing it out of my heart, but it is too long to finish. I start shouting as feeling eats. For a moment, feel like this cobra will gulp me in its big mouth. Feeling pain in chest, praying for help, then a fearful black seed from my face and chest it drawing out. It is also too long to draw, taking too much time. I am drawing into deep but feeling light. I am feeling like some powerful forces surrounded me and protected me. In noon, sleep for some time on the stone, but in few more minutes I felt like many cobras of different sizes, small, big, are running out of my body. Today I felt like a small size zenith in the form of waves moving outside of my body and fulfill all my sankalp commitments. In dream, saw a young yogi, not hatha yogi, tried to throw him out like unwanted guest, but he did not go out. His face is clear even after I wake up. I am seeing a light for divine tunnel in meditation. No thoughts of negativity for anyone. Next, Rajyoga is the power of thoughts, so incidents happen immediately. That doer is also unable to believe because incidents happen in some other world. Super conscious mind and be just imitate them. Physically, what you want to become, power of thoughts already made you, and you behave like puppets. Feeling lonely, I am depressed. The bad incidents work us to bring our bad tendencies on surface to clean. So welcome the good or bad, whatever comes on the way. As these thoughts or tendencies scattered our willpower, and we like to keep our power scattered. It does not work in particular direction. Feeling like something is flowing from the back after boiling in hurt. It helps to grow you fast, cure you from incidents towards outward. Text, today again creatures like snakes are running out of my heart. I slept in the divine lap due to fear. Then black particles are moving out with wind from whole body, and body enlightened with divine light from inside. Divine light is flowing around and through me continuously. Every other thing is leaving me automatically, and I am feeling like everything is done by divine power. I am feeling like positive divine and charge in form of waves are spreading out of me, grows more and more wide in surrounding environment. In meditation, I am seeing a young sadhvi in white dress, and there is an aura of divine light behind her head. She is giving continuous jars to me. Next, I am feeling some stretching in me. With this stretching, something is going out and something in form of waves is infusing in me continuously. In meditation, I am disturbed by a girl. Face is not cleared, dancing very fast, very, very fast, and I am unable to meditate. I tried my best, but her dance is not stopped. Then I am feeling some biscuits like bricks are moving out from body, especially from face, in large numbers. In evening during meditation, problem is solved, and now she is not disturbing me by dance. She is now out of my heart. In this life, I was very much devoted for dance, which is due to these past sanskars. Next, for me, everything is here and now, so no past, no future. This moment is free from every past or future moment. I am free from hurt. I am feeling better. I am trying to sleep for an hour, but as I lie, I start feeling waves of transmission in me and inside me, feeling like mouth of volcano is open and warm, dirty, dust and liquid is flowing out of it for more than an hour. From its mouth, a long chain of Ahuri Sadhu monsters, black layers are coming out of it. Pain is out of my bearing capacity. Sanskar of past several births are flowing out with the power of transmission of my Gurudev. I am feeling fear and ashamed. I am crying that my Gurudev, in form of divine light, shall not be dirty of this kutta. Many hours spent, I remain lie in the same position without movement, only a spectator of what is going on inside me. Today I am feeling 5 feet of Gurudev touched before God. In night, there is continuous cleaning and a point is signed in me. Next, today I feel a spark in heart like a thunder blaze in heavy rain. I am in deep meditation after some time. A clear vision is there. The same sparrow that fell in a bowl of dal in my dream with broken limb is raising its head, growing stronger. Its wings are developed wide and it is also increased in size. It was jeel, had jeel in it. The broken leg is also bitter. Then it holds the edges of the plate of food. I and sparrow are watching each other's eyes. We have a glint of satisfaction on our face. Then I seem like turning into that sparrow with two developed wide stretched wings at the back attached to heart. Have the same emotions in me. In the next moment, that bird flew away from my body towards the sky. As it both beings are developed now, I, the soul, stretched wings and starts flowing from my body towards the sky. Now I am seeing myself flying, liberating in the sky, above the clouds, deep down in the ocean of joy. I am clearly feels like singing birds with two wings. Now my both wings are developed now, materialistic and spiritual. Both are supporting me to fly in a balancing form in the sky. The cup of my heart is overflowing, chalka, with the continuous rainfall of divine love. Now I am able to interpret the dreams of pounded bird in my bowl of dal. Wealth for a bird is food grains which was filled in a bowl. When it fell and sunk its head into the bowl of dal, that means it was enriched with the wealth, but due to one wing and leg, not able to fly. Similarly, I had lots of riches, name and fame. People were attracted by my dance, gossips of my past, but I was not able to fly a balanced life, as the same was not the complete form of development. It is half growth, need to develop its other being through spirituality. This has no relationship with religion. Now the development is on flow and true happiness of finding me is here and now. Balance of personality will make me soar high and high and high. Nature gives all answers. It never leaves any question unattended or any demand created by your sanskar or thoughts unfulfilled. It is merely a supplier. It gives to me, then also to Mr. Thakur Vikram Singh, Ifroz Sahab, Mr. Kapoor, what they ask for by continuous longing without asking who you are. Like an engine for a motor, nature is a power, knows nothing about right or wrong. It goes where it is directed. So beware of power of choices, as it is a knife which may cut you or serve you, depending on which way you hold it. It has no man. That's which, why rich become richer, poor becomes poorer, failure attracts failure, until you develop love and faith and said, remains our history. Now I am master or co-creator or creator of my future, and take it in your hands and said, now I will make it as I want. Then nature supports you. So stop attracting negativity, cruelty, failure by transmitting it into nature by thoughts. What you thought creates demand, and nature only support, not interfere, without telling you, my child, I will not give it to you, as it is not good for you, it will destroy you. So never ask for vardaan, boon in prayer, because you have been given man and heart, this even kudrat don't have. Next, in dream I saw Dev, he is weak and ill. In meditation, I start feeling Dev, try to ignore him but not possible. There is no emotional misbalance like before. I start reading environment, there is something in it. I open my eyes and move towards the Hatha Yogi. First time I feel cold in my body. My dress is unable to save me from weather. I searched him at his usual place of sadhana. He usually sits on the rock inside the thick jungle, far from me, so my waves normally not affect him. He is not there. Then I start searching him. Yogiji, where are you? There is no response. I walked barefooted in the jungle and searched him at all best possible places. Suddenly I heard a voice. I moved toward that direction. After walking some time, I see the yogi grinding something with stone on the rock. I reached there. Suddenly my sight falls on the person lying there. I moved to him. Oh my God. I keep silent for a moment. Would you please help me to apply this ointment on his chest? Surely. And I take the bowl. He rubs his hand firmly on the person lying there. I am feeling nothing at this time. From bottom of my heart, the real Sambhav. Dev is lying there unconsciously. He is floating in the river. I saw him and drew him out. He is Dev. Yes, your natural waves drew him here in this thick jungle. I have nothing to say. There is no pick point in me. I just smile only. Let him rest for some time so that the medicine could have effect over him. He will get well soon. These are where sedative drugs applied on him. Next, I am in sleep. There is clear voice, Sambhav, Sambhav, Sambhav. And I start feeling like I am a sage. It must be the search of last bugs. There is a charge spreading around, having love and faith in itself. Then there is a vision of Lord Vishnu and their sage Nag, snake or cobra. Again a storm of black particles surrounded me. The automatic activities started in me, going deep in the meditation, then receiving a strong transmission. Then whole body turned into the sage Nag. The impression collected in a previous life have impact. Jina did puja of Nag that results in this vision. A thought to know the past births strike in the brain. Reply is there, skeleton in the medical college, bones and head in the hex, ashes flowing in the water of river, and land for many births, having your past birth impressions in itself. I'm feeling like having longing for siddhis for so many births. Now realizing anger in me, similar as a egoist, and hunger for power in this life I also had. Next, I opened the eyes. There is a Deo seeing me. He is sitting near to me, but there is no communication between us. Like our relation is a thing of last birth. Today there is grossness of energy and it is under control, so can be moved in desired direction. It is destroyed in me. The energy is doing the all deeds. There is no question of failure there. Faith has to be stronger. The chain of thoughts has been broken. I feel an instant thought in the evening during bath of Tattvagyan. There is a sense of to do service of others. During meditation, I am feeling like someone is drawing my own personality out of me very fast and it is mixing in something. There is a view, yet not cleared, something like man or woman. It is so fast that make me unable to even watch what is going on. Then I entered in the long cave made of elements like light. A sand is there. He is standing while turning his face towards me, and the cave is moving long and long. The charge falls on the head with force and speed. It is falling on whole body. There is increasing love in the environment, but not having any vision or of the type of romanticism felt earlier in life. All of three have meals of foods together. Nobody is uttering even a single word. Deo is imitating both of us. During the day, he is searching something everywhere. In the evening, he said something to the yogiji. Now there is no such need of that. But if you want to do, then I will save your head. I am like hearing nothing of their talks, so reacts nothing. We finished the dinner and at midnight, I sit for meditation as the word Param Tattva is haunting in my mind. I see the clear picture of another saint in my dreams who was trying to say something. During meditation, I get the answer of Param Tattva. I means energy. I am is the changed form of energy from one form to another. In whole universe, this energy is the same. Due to taking different form is looking different, so there is no existence of I. Whatever is happening was done or will be done by this energy only. The same energy in the everyone in the universe, whether living or non-living. Because of this same energy, all the five tattva, earth, water, sky, fire, wind, living and non-living are same. Therefore, the waves of thoughts travels from one place to other within no time and reacts in no time. The energy in this body may take any shape or form. In meditation, establish uniformity with this energy only. The tree and I and deer and the stone, everything is the same energy. But we are at different level of sensitivity, which is the stages of growth. So it grows and after millions of years reached to the level of sensitivity of human being. Human being stands at top of the growth stage. Energy in the stone is similar to the energy in the universe. Then there is no place for doubts and fears, as all of the things are of the same energy. This is the real meaning of Sambhav, seeing the same in all. The same energy takes form of gold as well as the stone at different level of growth. Feeling the same energy in all universe is seeing the reality. Incidence happens at the upper level than in this world. There will be no transmission of doubtful waves of thoughts so that the desired incidence takes place in the world at the right time. When whole universe is made of the similar energy, then having doubts about anything is like one hand is having doubt over other hand in same body. Next, during the day the past incidents appeared before having clear analysis on the basis of above Tattvagyana. If rose is entered in the life as I have keen desire to move out of the bare water and also have somewhat rust, not accepting very fast behavior. They were married to that lady because there is ego to prove that even I brought up in a beer bottle, I still have high ethics, like a role model. Still, before his marriage, your life was easy manageable. On listening the past story of parents attracted the Thakur Bikram Singh in my life. While in past, I have no contact with him in my any form with him. It was also representing the lust which I pressed in myself. All the persons I have contacted in life are reflections of my own thoughts and desires. While I blame the nature, which does not have even one, it just simply processes the demand I have created and present the best possible result. Therefore, thinking nothing is better than thinking ugly. At least I will not transmit the wrong thoughts in the universe, which will bump to someone else and also creates the demand. Dev is again before me because my longing draws him to me. Life is too much simple in its natural way, but I use the crane to lift a needle. I make it complicated with my own creation of thoughts. In the whole universe, whatever things I see, that is only the reflection of my own thoughts in ghost form. Like seeing my own image in the mirror, the virtue I see in the person is the same in me, reflection of my own inner self only. Even though so many complications I created, the kind nature gives the shelter and the opportunity to grow in full. Dev is sitting before Yogiji. Both of them are closing their eyes so not to create disturbance to them. I sit at some distance, silently. Just in few minutes, they open their eyes. How do you feel? Yogiji asked to Dev, out of the world. I never feel like this before in whole life. By saying this, eyes of Dev is filled with the tears of gratitude. I reached closer to them. I folded my hands to Yogiji and also talked with you. How are you? I can't express in words, he smiles. Come and join us, Jinat said. Yogiji first time called me with my name. It is surprising because for past so long time, I have not heard my name. We all sit there. I start searching something with my sight. Yogiji smiles and raises his sight to nearby tree and some fruits are slowly falls before us. It is not surprising for me as I know it's a child play for a yogi, practicing yoga for so long period. Dev and I thanked for his kindness. Then he starts talking himself. First time as I always see him silent, not uttering even a single word without reason. Have it in feeling of divinity in you. We obey him like a disciplined child. Would you like to know what is Dev practicing at that time? Yes, I replied in curiosity, because there must be something interesting in that. Actually, the divine grace is transferring in the heart of Dev through my heart. Nature chooses me to become a transmission pole to transmit the Pramahuti to the person it chooses, and Dev becomes the first. Wonderful. It means anybody could come and reside there will be able to receive the transmission. No need to stay here. I have done research over it. It can reach to any corner of the universe from any corner. It means no need to stay in jungle. Definitely just sit and close your eyes. It will flow on you like charge. You realize or not, but it will work upon you. And then they will start describing his experience. Don't you want to know that how Dev reached here? Yogi said it with a smile. Up to this moment, I realized that Dev is here due to only demand created by me in the environment. He starts saying, actually with help of transmission and other siddhis, I am able to receive the waves of thoughts. When you come here, two types of waves were there, one for Pramahuti and other for Dev. Therefore, I said you to return, as I can brought the Dev in your life back without practicing the Hatha Yoga. But your longing for Pramahuti was so strong that force me to allow you to stay here in this dangerous jungle, as well as presence of you would also proved me disturbing. But since you are here, I feel no such waves out of you. But I don't want that even after fulfilling your aim to receive Pranahuti, you reject the world. The second reason was that I want to test the Raj Yoga developed through this yoga practice. So I decided to bring him here by using images stored in your brain. And now one day, I find him floating in the river. His car met an accident, still he was alive, while floating many miles away from here. He reached here, the power and siddhis I got in just few months through this abhyasa we are practicing here. I am feeling that I have lost many years in Hatha Yoga. It did not move me forward from certain limits, and I increased the grossness in heart. Therefore, the effect of transmission started on me even after you, but after that, it worked very fast. Even I was unable to cope up with its speed. Now, Deo is also receiving the same and see the difference in him. But it is not prasad or food to be distributed to all. Nature selects the person for it, and then it opens the gate of its treasure for him. Living in jungle is of no use. You can bring peace and purity at your home with this yoga. I am so much pleased to hear it. Now all of us are enjoying the beauty. Yogi also starts to get rid of the dirtiness and the fearful personality he developed during the past years. He is cheerful person now, not escaping or irritating on the visitors who start coming to him. It becomes a regular treat there to give transmission. The person once meet him and request him, he gives the same to him, and they get tremendous development in the life. I am walking alone along with you on the bank of the river. Deo is seeing with me with love. Jinath, yes, would you accept me? I will live here forever. Deo, I am not the same that Jinath, whose beauty you loved. I am just handful of bones and nothing. I am here, happy now, I replied to him. He turned me and started seeing in my eyes. Raj Yoga is not for keeping it yourself. The nature provides to distribute it to the persons needed it. And how many people will be able to reach here? The last thing I want to ask that don't you have any duty to the society served you? Whether you realized or not, don't be so self-centric. I am just watching his face. Till this time, I make up the mind to settle here forever. I even forgot the person I left behind. Me. I am feeling thanks from bottom of my heart to the nature for its guidance to serve the society. The kind society who served me in whole life without complaint, even though I was totally so selfish person and cursed it in all the way. What about Yogiji? Should he not move out from this jungle? I said with smile. Definitely. So request to the nature and have firm belief to make the world full of divine love. He will surely come. That would be his second inning as well as of us also. Next, there is no need to tell anything to the Yogiji. Life is taking turn around. He is feeling somewhat uneasy. He is sitting on the rock, his favorite one. He seems brooding over the things which we now have to adopt in the near future. I am feeling somewhat uneasy. From childhood, when I was of 10 years old, my parents died and my Gurudev, who also was a Hatha Yogi, brought up me. I have never been in the society from that time. Now I have to move there, about which I did not know much. But I have to return its depths that it brought up till 10 years. I can't enjoy the peace here while the society is burning continuously in thirst of peace. We will help you. The next day to the full moonlight, we will move out. Thank you very much for listening. This is the end of chapter and page number 240. Return to the left world. Page number 241. All of us climbing the hill slowly, slowly, because the jungle. We reside in the other side of the society, also very far. There is no mode of conveyance, so we have to move on foot. I have beared the dress in which I reached the jungle. On reaching the top, all three of us folded our hands for showing our gratitude to the jungle. Then we moved towards the city. We hired a taxi for whole route. Dev has given him his wing, so he is happy and takes us to the destination. I asked him to give him much money on the destination. He is much impressed with the yogi. He touched his feet. Yogiji kept silence. Dev recognized the problem. He sells his other wing and watch. With that money, he brought some clothes for him. Yogiji in kurta and dhoti now. He is feeling somewhat difficult with the clothes, but he managed. Taxi driver keeps on talking all the day, talking about each and every place, prominent persons as well, as compliment both of us that we resembled the superstar Dev and Jian, love story and how Dev commit suicide after, that's it. We can't enjoy the service for which we have not paid, that is silence. We can't enjoy silence. We reached to the similar group of the Sri Krishna devotees. Nature already decides the plot. We met with them. We introduced the Yogiji. He gives them Pramahuti. I gave them the address for communication. Everybody is happy. I would never been able to feel that our research and siddhis are of so much importance to the society. Now I am feeling that limiting the benefits and knowledge of siddhis is a theft as well as he is the thief whom nature gives it. I tell the Yogiji about that studious girl and her problem. Yogi said that she will reach along with her aunt to our next destination. Then our taxi moved forward to the ashram. Now I am reached to the girl met at the seminar of astrologers, palmists, etc. I found her easily. She is in a room made outside of the main building of her. I asked for her. That studious girl is still facing problems in her career, failure after failure. She is completely depressed now. I listened the story of her past, how she failed in each and every field. She studied with written practice so much that her right hand, finger, soles, neck and head pained due to strain of written practice. She suffered a lot, but success was out of her reach. I said, first of all, take transmission that will burn the seed so they could not again disturb you. And after some time, new era of success starts in that studious girl's life. Now her hard work starts bearing fruits of success. Her aunt also received the Pramahuti, and the fear in traveling with family is the talk of past. Next, on one fine day, I moved on the road in taxi. Unexpectedly, see, the lady whom I promised the Pramahuti met in the ashram with her husband moving on the road in India. Stop, 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 I cried with joy. What's happened? Everybody said, and taxi just stopped near to them. I come out and be hugged with joy. Her husband is also smiling to see both of us. What a pleasant surprise. I'm not expecting you on the road. I screamed with joy. Now all men are out of the taxi. We moved to nearby restaurant. After having lunch, driver moved for some shopping. I tell the Yogiji all her problem and also the experience of the ashram, where first time I met to her. He closed his eyes and viewed the environment. After a few seconds, he opens his eyes. There is no soul disturbing you, Yogiji said. What she thought, when our own desires remain unfulfilled, then brain create havoc of imagination. It seems so real that a common person become unable to understand the reality of it. Then should I consult to doctor again, because I have already invested so much money in that? No, as these treatment or any other methods just suppress the seeds in you, and when these seeds get favorable condition, they start growing more fast than before. Then what to do? See, puzzled hopelessly. Nothing, only see needs transmission. Nature will transmit the divine power from my heart to your heart. and it will burn the seeds of that. Then all of us moved to the room of hotel attached to restaurant. Yogiji sits in a position of samadhi. That sister also sits before him and closed her eyes. Almost 1 hour has been passed. Yogiji opens his eyes. She has tears in her eyes. I never feel such burning fire inside me. Thank you from bottom of my heart. Sister, please do not spit on the clean floor. So take care of this condition. I will obey each word uttered by you. Then he tells the whole system of meditation and how it works. Now the turn of husband, he sits and receives transmission. Both husband and wife tell about the pain felt in heart and the head. That is because of transmission and nothing serious about that. Now I will transmit it to you and please tell me the time when you feel comfortable to receive the transmission. The same time. Until this the driver also reached in the room. Yogiji also gives transmission to him. After this, he is feeling sad that he charged for the taxi. He tried to return the ring, but they refused to do the same. Now the final destination is the Mumbai. We all reached there. Yogiji is watching it with full. Taxi driver narrates him about everything of the Mumbai, approximately 100 movies he described to him. In his interesting chit-chat and also doing our duty to transmit the pranahuti to the persons already received it, as well as cleaning the environment by transmitting the love and trust we reached at the gate of Koti. The very first person we see there is the Sahajadi Begum. She is lean without jewelry and palm. I just rushed to her and hugged her tightly from the back. She is full of surprise. First time in life I saw her weeping. She is trying to hide her tears. Then I introduce her to the Yogiji. We all enter the house. She welcomes him with full heart and also offers him paan. We burst into laughter. Where is it for Sahib? I asked to her. Kis namurad ka naam le rahi hai? What the hell you are talking about, Sahajadi Begum? She smiles and said, after that interview and when you left the house, nobody comes here. I have heard that he is doing the profession of grooming the girls for becoming heroine. Wonderful. But today is my real Eid. We all four make the family. Three of them followed the rules, all rules of jungle at home also. Sahajadi Begum listened the all of the yoga. She was unable to believe that such power is exist, which could burn the seeds of the karma stored at heart and also works 24/7 basis. She becomes the first at Mumbai who received the transmission. The all persons who already received the transmission came to the house for regular transmission, and with them new persons also attracted. There were many persons in the past used to come to Sahajadi Begum, but this is the first time when persons come to her with the pious feeling in heart. She is overwhelmed with the feeling to serve them. They are the regular visitors for them. The news of our return and also planning of marriage with you spread all over the film industry. But this time, instead of gossip, there are headlines of news. Return of Jeenat and Theo, who rock the Indian cinema. Welcome back, Jeenat and Theo. Now the countdown begins for stunning performance. Many film producers are in the line to take me in their film. Here Theo is also start his production house and I have to support him. If Rose also heard the news of my arrival, but due to the long time has been passed, he has no strong feeling for me like before. There are many charming ladies around him. Sahajadi Begum is surprised to see that why all those dogs are not rushed to bite me. Mr. Kapoor is the shrewd man. He is very intelligent, enough to understand that how to use the publicity of an actor for his film. He did this in the past also. He announced a film having a star as me and Theo. The meeting is fixed at bungalow of the Theo. He anticipates that I will abuse and blame him for all the past things he did. So he prepared himself mentally. We dressed as before like the professional stars. He reached at the right time with a big smile on his face. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Gina, the superstar in industry, welcome back. He said with Jeet at the door of the bungalow. I also welcomed him. We proved the anticipation wrong to Mr. Kapoor. No sign of past is on our face. Mr. Kapoor rearranges himself with this unexpected positive situation and pretends like everything is normal among all three of us. Deo makes two drinks, one for himself and another for Mr. Kapoor. He offers one to him and held another one in his hand. I sit beside him without moving my face towards Deo. I take the glass of wine from his hand and keep it on the table near to Mr. Kapoor. I touched Deo's face with my finger softly and now turn my face to Deo. We see in each other's eyes with a smile. This is the wonderful, perfect communication ever been conducted before with any alcoholic person. I hold Deo's hand in one of my palms and cover it with my second palm. Discussion remain uninterrupted. Mr. Kapoor had charged himself so much to rock the meeting, but not find even a single chance to comment on this small, beautiful incident. In this evening, Mr. Kapoor is alone, who is taking drink, and we only discuss the project to be started. Deo, I have announced a film to have both of you as stars. It will be blockbuster, super. Without even asking us, Deo comment with a smile. I know that Deo is not feeling comfortable and also pain for past for me in his heart, I add. Let's have dinner first to make the situation easy. Sure, I am also feeling hungry. All of three reached to the dining table. Mr. Kapoor, we need time to think, I said with a smile. Sure, I am not in hurry. We will be pleased to maintain professional relationship with you, I said while serving salad in his plate. Deo is packing all memories of his past in the room to make it able for welcome of their newly married life. I am also helping him. Suddenly, a photo of Deo's marriage I found. I show it to Deo. He takes it in his hand. I smile with some contentment mixed with some grief spread on his face. I will always wish her a happy life. How you dare to talak? I ask him. Deo lost in the memories. On that night, I had drank so much. At that condition, she fought so much with me. Kya jaldi hai tumhe khud ko dafan karne ki? Why you are in haste to be buried in grave? I replied nothing, only listened to her. She keeps on shouting at me. Suddenly, I bent on my knees and see in her eyes. She shocked on my reaction, on action. Please leave your life. I am culprit. Forgive me. She said, sat up. I'm your culprit, I repeated. Please go away of my life, otherwise it will be too late. You are getting mad. You are saying me for talaq and remarriage. You are not conscious, you fool. Yes, I am saying right. Somebody else is in my soul. Therefore, I will never be able to give you your right. Hug. What a fool you are. I am Brahmin. I can't remarry in this world. But why? The society. After 50 years, when circumstances would change from now, our parents would not be there to support us. They would die till that time. I would also not be with you at that time. Then you would regret that why you don't show courage to take the right decision 50 years back. Please feel it now. You would be mad with depression when nobody will be with you to love you truly. Without love, life will seem deserted. Deo, you are mad. What our parents, what they feel, they have some expectations with us, with our relation. It is better to break that relation which makes the life hell. Look, Gina had left me so that our life would be succeed. But I am failed badly. She also bent on her knees and looked at my face, eyes. There is only a friend in my eyes. I said, please don't become a puppet in the hands of society because it cares for nobody. Move on to restart your life. This is the blank check for your new life. I picked the checkbook and signed it. Please do not care for society. Listen to your heart I wished you a happy life forever. We took divorce and wished happy life to each other. This was the headline of the newspaper. Families and relatives of both of us cursed and abused us. May not be happy ever. Go to hell. Nachaniya dancer kahin ka. You dancer, sit. Naak katwa di. Viston ki nautanki dikha di. Show the show of the relationship. But who cares? They were lost in those thoughts. I shake him. He smiles with tears in his eyes. I hugged him. Two drops also rolled out of my eyes. It is true. Jiske samne aap has sakte hain, uske saath aap pura din bita sakte hain. Lekin jiske samne aap ro sakte ho, uske saath puri zindagi bita sakte ho. The person with whom you can laugh, you can spend the whole day with him. But the person with whom you could cry, you can spend the whole life. Next. All four of us are sitting in a meditation hall. Be thanks to divine flame for our life, for everything we have. Actually, this is the prayer in real sense. I start going deep and deep. A vision is clear before eyes. A liquid like tar, a material with the help of which road are made in India. Start releasing from my whole system of body in huge quantity, very dirty, felt vomiting, whole body turned black. Black seems like boiling tarmac. Roads are made of it, or like silt of gutter. Then all this boiling tarmac start drawing from upper side. Flesh of the body starts peeping out. During this process, Gurudev, in the form of divine light, enters into the heart. I am feeling ashamed on this untidy condition and also feeling sorry that his clothes be dirty, have spots on dirty tar or tarmac. Now feeling lightness in body, he cleans the system through hands. Shower of divine light starts falling on my head continuously. There is a clean place made in the heart so he can stay and move. A circle of light starting from my heart spread around me, going on and on, bigger and bigger. Next. In the next morning in meditation, there is a lotus with closed petals full of burning fire inside me and whole my body enlightened. I am feeling a magnetic power drawing my upper body upper side. My body is feeling like flying and becoming lighter. A spark is felt in my heart strongly. Now I am in the galaxy among the stars. There are sands of high order. I am among them, but there is no communication among us. I opened my eyes after an hour and start thinking what was going in inside me. In one free noon, I start discussing about the Lucknow quota with Sajjad Begum. This is a topic she irritates much. She starts ignoring it. Whatever thing were going on there, whatever the people of society think about that, but there I got you by Sajjad Begum, who brought up me. She feels somewhat normal with these words. Sajjad Begum, don't you think you have to do something for that? Don't ever dare to expect that I would think even about that. She cut my statement in between. I could understand the feeling of her. No one woman would ever like to be there, but this does not end up my responsibilities towards society. After a few minutes of talk about here and there, I start my efforts to convince her to fulfill my vision. Sajjad Begum, we draw resources from society for our life. Nature gives what we demand, not only for us, but to pass it to the right persons. Jinat, I will not go there. That is hell. And they are still in that hell. Look, Khuda will surely help them one day like he helped us. Are you saying it? The past records of that bear worth it. How many times Khuda come as savior? Khuda is. He gives us the sense, power, resources, not only to get benefit of it like a thief, but to help those brothers who are not lucky like us. We should become like illuminating lamp टू गिव देम डायरेक्शन एंड राइट. जी नाथ, सी इज राइट. योगी जी इज जस्ट सेड इट. ही जस्ट एंटर्स इन टू द हॉल आफ्टर गिविंग प्रावाहुति टू द पर्सन सीकिंग इट. इट इज अ क्राइम टू लिमिट द प्रावाहुति पावर एंड आवर रिसोर्सेज ऑफ नॉलेज वेल्थ इंटेलिजेंस अप टू ओनली यू एंड मूव अराउंड इट लाइक अ हैन कुकू कुकू. योगी जी कंटिन्यूज, इट इज आवर ड्यूटी टू शेयर इट विद ऑल, स्पेशली विद दोज हु इज इन नीड. देव ऑल्सो एंटर्स एंड लिसन आवर डिस्कशन. ही ऑल्सो अफर्म्स इट. हैंड्स विच हेल्प टू द नीडी पर्सन आर बेटर देन दोज हैंड्स विच वेस्ट इन द इबादत. शहजादी बेगम स्टार्ट थिंकिंग. नाउ द पॉजिटिव वेज आर ऑन हर फेस. She said, all of you are right. I became somewhat selfish. But now overcome of this feeling. All of us now at the same level of mindset. We start discussing the matter. Next. Now barking dogs are not disturbing us. I and Deo decided to go for a walk on Juhu Beach. We are walking and having coconut water. We are lost in each other's talking. Suddenly, journalists and photographers surrounded us and start question. We are now comfortable. When will you marry Gina Saiba? I only smile, having a straw in my mouth, gulp the coconut water and say, give me your address and phone number. I will send you a special invitation card of our marriage. This becomes a happy interview. We are answering in such a jolly mood that every answer makes them laugh. After 15 minutes, all of them leave us. Again, we get busy with each other. Jeenath, yes, I again fall in love with you. Do you accept me? I burst into laughter. You are a nice guy, but I need some time to think. They also smile. You will never change your nakra. Tantrum. Both of us start walking. After a few minutes, I see, oh, Ifro Sahib. They also pays his attention to him. Ifro Sahib is surrounded with girls and delivering high-five dialogues among them. There is a distance of almost few meters between us. I have mischievous idea in my mind. Yes, in mind, because heart don't think. I turned my face so that my face would be toward Deo while back towards the Ifros. Therefore, Deo in a position to see Ifros while I don't. I am standing like thinking something and said, an astrologer has seen my palm and predicts that my would-to-be husband is an eccentric person, not allowed that, 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 that. Dear, don't start again. By saying this, he draws me towards himself and holds me tightly with his arms around my shoulder. I again burst into laughter. You naughty girl. Dear also smiles. Ifros is busy in his routine job. Next, Sajadi Begum starts planning to convince the ladies in Bearbother, as he could feel that nobody would allurement. Nobody without allurement be ready to move forward on the path of spirituality. This new job is the real test for her being human in real sense. And after great toil of many persons, they'll start a new era. The ladies there start meditation with receiving Pramahuti in their heart. But in their heart, there is a feeling of hesitation. We are feeling this, Yogiji said to them. So as we progress to be aware from the beginning, all that I am proud of, that I am ashamed of, is going to disappear. Because I cannot have only one side of the coin disappear, leaving the other in my purse. So this practice of Pramahuti has many. What should be self-evident facts and features which most of our pupil do not understand. Yogiji is happy as he could serve the society in better way. Many overseas practitioners start giving volunteer services in education, health, sanitary, as well as gaining their doubts. There is an interesting question raised by one of the practitioners as why the children of worthy parents turned corrupt. The answer of this question is given by Yogiji as, our sperms make only body, but the spirit enters in that body depends on the thoughts and inner condition of the parents. So if the parents have animal or monster at the time of conception, then a spirit which reacts also the same. Similarly, the child would be born with those sanskar. There, when you decide about first read your own condition, so your child would be the result of love, not of lust. The answer itself contained the mystery revealed, as the only parents are responsible to bring the bad spirit on the earth. We have started the new wing of education. We contribute a certain percentage of our income towards the development of this area. During meditation, the ladies experienced the bad tendencies releasing out of them, which make them pure and humble. It develops them completely so that they could think beyond the bare bottle. This whole area turned the center for arts, and the citizens of other parts of the globe come to study the model on which it is developed. There start new experiments in the various other fields as well as in spirituality. The vision we see in the jungle is now come to. Now there are many poles of transmission. Through them, the charge of pure love is transmitting in whole universe. Life is too short to spend another day behaving like victim. So dare to say, with full commitment to yourself, remains our history. This is the end of page 257. Postscript. There is difference between Karma Yoga and Raj Yoga. Karma Yoga without Prana Hoti, Raj Yoga with Prana Hoti. In Karma Yoga, do your karma and surrender it to the God. In Raj Yoga with Prana Hoti, nature is the doer. So no question of surrender of the karma. Second, in Karma Yoga, no right to think about the results. In Raj Yoga, assumption is taken that work has been done here and now, so no need to think about results. Endless struggle in Karma Yoga. Raj Yoga is simple and natural. Fourth, in Karma Yoga, driving force is you. Can't take the decision of not doing the work. In Raj Yoga, we have the master, supreme lover of any soul, who transforms us, and the principles which governs it are love, trust, discipline, obedience. Fifth, Karma Yoga takes much time as your sanskar are not removed and nature may deny your growth instantly. Raj Yoga removes the past now, so takes much less time to give results. Sixth, in Karma Yoga, my responsibility. In Raj Yoga, his responsibility. Seventh, in Karma Yoga, do the work without attaching with it. In Raj Yoga, there is only obedience. Eighth, in Karma Yoga, no assurance regarding success even after sincere practice. Raj Yoga gives guarantee of success. Ninth, but after sincere practice of Karma Yoga, your growth in Raj Yoga is greater than any other cult science. But Raj Yoga comes when boundaries of Karma Yoga ends. Above difference is based on my own practice of Karma Yoga and Raj Yoga. If anybody wants to challenge the above statement, he could do so only after having practice of both yogas for a long time, as I do. Currently, supreme lover of any soul is giving the transmission, and anybody can reach him. At the end, in short, I want to brief about the matters of the novel so that you can feel what a mystery have been revealed to you in this novel. The transmission of Pramahuti, also called Bijdagdh, that is burning the seeds of past inside you. Without Pramahuti, practicing Bhagavad Gita's Karma Yoga is like digging the land but not cleaning the mud, as well as not constructing the building. What is transmission of Pramahuti? It is the utilization of divine energy for recreating the present and burning the past impressions collected around the soul, which we have to bear in this life or in coming lives. If these impressions are not removed, then new impressions are also added to it. Then a new never-stopping wheel starts moving on and on the endless journey. In Pramahuti, this wheel is moved in reverse direction only. यू वुड नॉट बिहेव हैव द सेम एक्सपीरियंसेस ड्यूरिंग मेडिटेशन एज आई हैव बिकॉज इट डिपेंड्स ऑन द इंटरनल कंडीशन ऑफ यू इट क्योर्स यू फ्रॉम इनसाइड इट ऑल्सो अपोजेज द व्यू दैट फॉर स्पिरिचुअलिटी यू नीड टू स्केप टू जंगल एज वी डिड नॉट हर्ड अबाउट ब्रह्मचर्य बिफोर शंकराचार्य जी इट इज टोटली अगेंस्ट द नेचर इन ट्रांसमिशन एंड मेडिटेशन देर इज ऑल्सो नो नीड ऑफ कैलिबेसी ब्रह्मचर्य एंड मूविंग टू जंगल इट इज बेटर टू हैव पीस ऑफ जंगल एट होम रेदर देन हैविंग होम इन माइंड इन जंगल दिस बुक इज मेनली टू बर्न द फायर इन योर हर्ट फॉर प्राणाहुति ट्रांसमिशन सो यू कुड स्टार्ट अ जर्नी फॉर इट इट इज ऑल्सो डिक्लेयर्ड दैट नो बुक कुड गिव हेल्प यू टू फाइंड द प्राणाहुति ट्रांसमिशन फॉर इट ओनली योर कंटिन्यूस लॉन्गिंग कुड हेल्प यू फॉर सर्च ऑफ दैट इफ यू नीड देन आई वुड हेल्प यू टू फाइंड द राइट पर्सन फर्दर दिस इज ऑल्सो रिकमेंडेड दैट डू नॉट फॉलो अ प्रे ऑफ सो कॉल्ड सन्यासीज और बाबा एज इट कैंट बी प्रीच्ड इट ओनली वर्क अपॉन यू Who know it will not say anything. Who don't know will tell you this or that story. So just test it and approve it. It does not have anything like religious ceremony or rituals. It works in silence. As in its center, it supports only the view that nature provides the power to achieve. What you choose without asking who you are. As we have the power of choices, it never asks you about your choice, whether it is correct or harmful. So, remains our history warned you while making choices. It is a deadly weapon in the hands of a human being which nature provides. It says only, Tathastu, Tathastu, Tathastu. All the dictators in the world during the past snatched the power of choices first, whether knowingly or not, the actual impact of it. Otherwise, they would never be able to rule over the population in ranks with the help of soldiers, much lesser in number in comparison to the people resides there. Anybody could see this in the underdeveloped section of the world. Either they did not know the power of choices in hand, or this power of choices is snatched in fields. In politics, like choosing the administration under they want to live, as well as social and personal development. Like schooling, dresses, career, therefore they are weak even today. Only central characters have stories, not the rest. And if a female occupies an important place in the story, then she must have to go from minus. We keep on chanting all the time, Karm karo or phal ki chinta mat karo. Do your work and don't think about the wizards. It's like daydreaming of flying with single wing. You have to get support of transmission. As it burns the past impressions of the karma, so new seeds could be sown in the field and at the higher level, impression of your karma also stops to make. If anybody wants to check the authenticity of the statement above, he can do so by receiving transmission and meditation from the persons. Just have faith in it, only after testing it. And it did not take many years, it will prove itself. The scientist of Pranahuti has rediscovered it and made a good chain of spiritual trainer who would help you everything you can't buy with money. It is strongly recommended that we must fulfill the commitment to ourselves for our own development, physical, mental and spiritual. Warning. Please do not read many times the experiences of the Jinnat given in the novel at right place during meditation and pranahuti, as your brain will absorb these experiences and stop you from progress in the journey and will present the illusionary picture to you. Then you will be trapped in it. That will be worst situation for you. It is hereby declared that this novel does not have any connection with any religion, person, incident, caste, personal sentiments, country, etc. Thank you very much. D. Ramchandra. This is end of the book and page number 262. Thank you very much for listening. Have a nice day.